Welcome to yet another episode of Webcam Woes. I want to introduce something at the beginning of every episode from here on out to centralize, well, I guess, or easier way to put it, to make it make sense or give a reason as to, well, why this topic being chosen is chosen. So the topic is being nice or being weak. And why did I pick this one? Well, essentially, at least for my life, I've had to struggle with, am I being too nice or am I being weak? In the past, I used to not like confrontation pretty much at all, or being aggressive in any way, so I kind of was way over passive or way too nice as a sort of, I guess in a way, a defense mechanism, if you want to call it that. And now that I'm kind of sorting, rebalancing that or recalibrating that in a way, I can kind of see where I went wrong, and I want to make sure that you guys, if you guys feel like, or guys and girls, I should say, if you feel like, oh, am I being a pushover? Am I being too nice? Why does everybody do this to me? Okay, I'm going to give you some reasons, at least for what I've seen, as to why that happens, or better yet, how you can fix it if you want to. So look for the ways that you can express yourself in different areas of life. For example, if you don't like yelling at somebody or you don't want to fight somebody, you could figure out a way to just talk to them and get your point across without getting to the point where you have to yell, you have to scream, or whatever the case is. Or there's a way you can show them without communicating, like, don't do that part, I lied. You still want to communicate what your issue is, but you don't have to be aggressive or a dickhead to go about it. Do you voice your concerns? If you don't tell anybody there's a problem, 9 times out of 10, they're not going to know. And then that one chance that they do know, they're probably going to use that as a reason or an excuse to keep on doing what they're doing because they still want to, or they're waiting on you to do something about it. It's fucked up, it's sad, it's scary, I know, but that most of the time, that's why. So if you don't tell anybody or don't voice why you're upset, trust me, it's not going to change. This is kind of a play on the last one. So let's say there's 3 people. If it's me and a friend or associate and somebody else, if I have a problem with the friend, but I don't tell the friend, though when it's me and the other person, I tell the other person, oh, you know, friend A is kind of a dickhead. I don't like how he talks, or I don't like how he makes me feel, whatever. But you never tell friend A the issue. A, you're kind of being bitch made, and that's kind of fucked up. And 2, you're still not telling the person the issue, and you're kind of making it worse because you're telling somebody else instead of telling the other person. So now it's going to make it seem like you don't know how to communicate, or it's going to make you seem like you're weaker than you are, or it's just going to cause more issues. So it's like I said the last time, you don't have to be a dickhead or aggressive to get your point across. However, I would recommend that you know how to, that way you're not scared of it. Even more so, beyond that, just talk to the person that you have an issue with. Don't involve other parties, because then it just creates a whole bunch of drama and shit that you really don't need in this situation to begin with. But 4, do you pride yourself on being the nicer person? Sometimes you might take the high road just because it's the high road, or if you like, man, everybody thinks I'm so nice, or I gotta keep up this nice persona, or whatever the case is. If you're being nice for the sake of being nice, not because you actually genuinely want to be, that does not help. It's only gonna make more pressure on you, because when you snap, trust me, you will, you're gonna not want to be nice anymore, and then you're gonna figure out who you really are. And if you were putting on a nice mask, that was actually a lot of hard words to say in a sentence, try it. If you put on a nice mask, then once it falls off, who are you really? You know what I mean? Don't be a fake nice person just because it's the nice thing to do, because then you're actually not being nice. Do you regret any choices that you make? So kind of what I said last time, if somebody was saying something to you and you didn't like it, and you didn't say something, or you kind of let them continue to be an asshole towards you, or you could have done something but you chose not to and now you regret it, then you know that's not what you should have done, because now the situation's over, it's in the past, there's no way to change it. Though you right now are living with that hole in your heart of, damn, I wish I would have, I wish I could have, I would have been different if I, Yeah, all that shit's kind of over with because you can't go back and change it. So to avoid living with those, especially the worse the moment, excuse me, didn't mean to hit the mic, the worse the moment is for you, if you kind of just let that simmer and sit and you're like, oh my God, I wish, then just do the thing that you wish you would have done, or a version of it, depending on what it is. I'm not going to tell you to kill somebody if that's what you want to do. However, make sure you express yourself. That way you don't leave a situation wishing you could have done something different, because that, my friends, is a way harder problem to fix if it ever gets fixed at all. I'm going to, on my script, I had them in a certain way, but I'm going to flip it. It'll make sense. So the first one is, do you feel undervalued, or do you personally feel weak? Do you feel like people respect you? That's the first thing. If the answer is it's an immediate no, that's a problem. If do you even know what respect is? Because a lot of times if you get disrespected and you feel undervalued, you might not even know what having value is or what strength really looks like. So you won't even know. You'll be so used to being weak that you'll just kind of accept it. Or if you do know what having strength is and you choose not to do it or not to use it, that's more of a self-image confidence thing, and that's a little bit more than I have the credentials to copy. I mean, not copy, to tackle right now. So if you do feel weak and you don't really stick up for yourself, or you don't really correct anybody when they try to disrespect you, again, you don't have to be a dickhead or be aggressive. Sometimes you still might, but you can definitely start, or however I should say, you can definitely start to try to stand up for yourself. Even if you have to start extremely small, that's better than saying nothing at all. Kind of going off my last point, which is why I switched them. When the situation's over, when the argument's done, when you leave the situation, whatever the case is, do you have all the right answers or insults, depending? Like, oh man, I wish I would have been able to say this. But you have those epiphanies after the situation's over. Like, you know everything you could have said, should have done. Oh man, I would have fucked him up. Or I would have said this shit to him. Or, oh, she can't do that. But you're doing all that after the situation. So in reality, you couldn't. Because if you could have, if you could have done everything you said you were trying to do, guess what? You probably would have done it by now. And funny enough, a lot of those, oh man, I would have, or oh shit, she can't, or oh man, he ain't gonna, all those things are kind of, at least in my opinion, a form of regret, because now you're projecting or trying to rewrite history in a way, or like kind of trick your mind into saying what you would have done that you didn't do to kind of like ease yourself into existing. You know what I mean? Does everyone that you interact with, do they disrespect you, or do they comment on every little thing that you do? Do people even value you? Do you yourself feel weak? If the answer to any of these questions are yes, you have a serious self-image, self-confidence issue. That is way more than I have the ability to talk about right now. However, I will give you this advice. Don't be a dickhead. Don't be aggressive, though you can still stand up for yourself in any little way. Also, don't try to throw the, oh, I wish I would've, or he ain't gonna do, or she can't do this, because most of the time, if you could have, you would have, and you wouldn't be talking about it, because it's something you just do, not think of doing. You're kind of filling that empty hole with lies and a dream to kind of like keep going, in a sense, but it's really dangerous and toxic, because you're kind of hyping yourself up to do something that you're not really ready to do, or if you do it, it's not something you really truly want to do or are able to do, so you're kind of stuck. That's all I got. Again, this one, I want to start kind of making it, there's a theme throughout all these episodes, so I'm going to start introducing the why during all these. I gotta go, there's some shit going on at the moment, so with that being said, you know, if you got any, I don't know why I started typing on an invisible keyboard, but if you got any topics that you want to see, put them in the comment section below. Do the standard YouTube procedure, like, comment, subscribe. I appreciate you making it this far. You don't have to, but I appreciate it that you do. And I will catch you guys on the next one.